This is a story called The Iciest, Diciest, Scariest Sled Ride Ever by me, Rebecca Rule, with illustrations by Jennifer Thurms. On the first day of February vacation, sleet followed snow and made a crust so thick you couldn't break through even if you jumped on it as hard as you could. The largest of the three LaPierre brothers tried. He jumped up and down, but he couldn't break through. My little brother Robert slid down the slope in our backyard like a hockey puck. In the puppy snowsuit he got for Christmas, he bumped into the snow-softened stone wall. It looked like fun, so we all tried it. The LaPierres, my two best friends, Patty H and Patty P, and me. We bounced off the stone wall and then had to form a human chain to pull everybody back up the little hill. The world was ice and we were skaters without skates. We decided to look for a really good sliding place. Patty H tested her snow saucer on the hill by Raymond's Brook. She spun all the way down. Plowing backwards through the pucker brush at the bottom, I got ready to go. "Forget it, Lizzie," she yelled up to me. "You can't steer on this stuff." "We'll meet you at the bridge," I yelled down. Then I remembered the old Travis sled in Grandpa Bud's barn. It was homemade, two double runner sleds hitched to a plank seat. When Grandpa Bud was a kid, he said you could push off from his house at the stroke of noon, whiz down Old Mountain Road, past the horse farm, past the mill, past the blacksmith shop, whip around the corner, go past the cemetery, past the church, past the skating pond, swoosh into the village, and spin to a stop in the snowbank by the gazebo before the bell finished ringing the hour. Course, then it took us the rest of the afternoon to hike home, Grandpa Bud said. "Please," we said, "please, please." "I don't know about this," he said. "It's awful icy." We promised not to break the Travis. "Just don't hurt yourselves," he said. "Hit a soft spot in the crust, things could get dicey." We promised not to break ourselves. "It's hard to steer on crust," Grandpa Bud said. "Get going too fast, it's pretty scary." "We're not scared," we said. "We'll try to go slow." We're pretty sure he didn't believe us about the slow part. We didn't believe ourselves. "And stay out of the road," he warned. "Times have changed." An icy glaze coated the highest, mightiest, iciest sledding hill off Old Mountain Road. We'd sledded here before on saucers, cardboard boxes, and once on my cousin Poppy's flexible flyer, but never on a sled as big as Grandpa Bud's Travis, and never on a crust like this. The smooth surface was so bright it hurt our eyes. The hilltop glared in the sun. Two LaPierre boys pulled the Travis. Patty P pushed. We couldn't stand. Once it got steep, our legs kept slipping right out from under us, so we crawled. I could hear Robert's snowsuit swishing behind me. He grabbed my boot. I tried to shake him loose. We both rolled all the way down the hill and wedged up against a small hemlock tree. Soon, the three LaPierres, the two Patties, and the Travis joined us. Pig pile! "We need climbing ropes and pitons," the LaPierres said. "We need cleats," Patty P said. "We'll never make it," Patty H said. "We need sticky mittens," Robert said, "and spiky knees." "We need a hot air balloon," I said, "for floating up." We locked hands and feet, and then on our bellies, we wormed up the slope, an inchworm train with a Travis caboose. We made it about halfway before LaPierre lost his grip. "I'm going," he cried, and went taking a patty or two with him. I rolled over, threw up my hands, and enjoyed the ride all the way down. Pig pile! Let's go to my house and have cocoa, Patty H said, but we ignored her. We took to the trees at the edge of the field. A Lapierre tied the Travis to his waist with the sled's pulling rope. The crust seemed softer here, soft enough to dig in a toe. We hugged trees all the slip-slide way to the top. The three Lapierre boys formed a human chain with the Travis at the end of it. Once we reached the height of land, we followed the ridge to the top of the highest, mightiest, iciest sledding hill off Old Mountain Road. We saw white, bright mountains. We saw the racing horse weather vane on the roof of Grandpa Bud's barn. We saw the steeple of the church. We saw the frozen pond. No one said, "I'm afraid," but we were a little. We played one potato, two potato to see who would steer, and I won. Behind me, my brother, the two Patties, and the three Lapierres squished together. Ready, set, the highest, mightiest, iciest sledding hill off Old Mountain Road stretched before us like a lifetime. I straightened the steer bar and braced my knees. Robert buried his runny nose in my back. The last Lapierre gave a little push and off we went. Slow at first, then fast, then faster. Someone screamed. It was me. The runners on the old Travis remembered how to glide. The hill took control and we were flying, flying over the highest, mightiest, iciest sledding hill off Old Mountain Road. We were going so fast the tears blew out of our eyes. We were going so fast we forgot to be scared. Some of us laughed, some of us screamed, some of us barked, some of us did all of it at the same time. The wind whipped our screams and laughter like a beautiful scarf trailing wildly behind. At the bottom, Robert crawled out from under the pile of Lapierre's, Patty's, and me. With the Travis, bottoms up on top, he wiped his nose with his mitten. He gazed up in wonder at the long, steep slope we had just careened down. He said, "Let's do it again." So we did. The end.